Hey friends, welcome back to Bitfumes. I'm your host Sarthak and you can also call me Ankur. This is a channel where I talk about Laravel and the cool thing about Laravel. So if you are new to this channel, don't forget to subscribe. This is a very important thing. Okay, so in this episode, database seeding of the Laravel. So why do you need a seeding? But before that, what is seeding? So what is seeding? So the seeding is just the way of putting a dummy data inside your database. So why you need seeding? Let's say you have this user table, and inside the user table you have name, email, password. And if you want to test your system you have just created, so you want obviously the data inside the user table. So if you need 2 or 3 data, you can obviously put that data in by using the insert option or by using the system you have created. But when you need 50, 100 or even 500 rows in your table, then how will you do that? So to save your time, to save every effort you will put in creating a dummy data, then here's the database seeding. So let's see how this works. You can see we have this user tables, and go to this database folder. We have already know what the database folder because we have generally worked with the migrations, but it's now time for seeding. Okay, seeds. So let's see what this folder has. This folder has database seeder.php. Let's see what is inside this. Inside this, there is something we does not know. Okay, so for that, I will just go to the Laravel documentation. And so in this documentation, when you go little down, you will see this thing. So let's just copy this and paste it here and let's see what happened. So obviously we have given something like DB, okay, and table. That means DB table, users, we are working on the user table, and now insert. Name will be strandom10. Email will be strandom@gmail.com. Password will be decrypt of secret word. Okay, so how will we insert this data inside our database? So for that, we will go to our command prompt. And we will type php artisan seed. Okay, let's say we have to do db seed. Okay, now we have successfully done. That means we does not have any error. So let's see what happened behind the scene. So we will go to our database, and when I refresh here, you can see there is a single dummy data, and you can see this is the random number, a random word. This is also a random word which is created by this command. Okay, so obviously we can see if we want to create a dummy data, we are ready to go. But now this is not the real use of seed. As I told you, we want to create lots and lots of data in one go. Okay, so how will we create that? Because this system has only created one row, but we want 50 row. So let's see how we will do that. For that, let's just go to Sublime Text again and undo everything from here, and let's type here factory, and here I will say app user, and here I will say class, comma, 50. And now let's just use the create command, and it's done. And let's go run the command, and you can see it says unable to locate factory with the name default app/user. Okay, here's the problem, capital U. And let's go again, try to run the command, and you can see it's taking time and no error. That means we have done something. So let's see what the something is. We will go to the user table click a refresh, and now you can see there are 50 rows created. So let's see all these rows. So we expecting 51 row, that means one row from the last command and 50 row from this command. And you can see this has original name of something. Okay, so this has a name with a email ID also, and password and something else. Okay, so you can see the seed function is used to create the user, but we have to see what this command says. This command says use the factory. And what is factory? For that, when you will go to this database factories folder, and inside that factories folder you have model factory. Let's see what is inside this model factory. You have a factory defined app user class, and we have actually used this factory by giving the app user class name. Okay, and what it says create a user by using a fake generator, faker. Okay, so we are using faker, and faker is creating a name, faker is creating a unique email, faker is creating the password with big crypt of secret word and remember token of random number. So this command is going to run 50 times. That means it is creating the 50 users in your table. So if I say here, let's say 10 and save it and run the command, so we are expecting more 10 users inside our table. So let's see, we want 61. That is correct, we have the 61 users inside our table, and these all are unique. So we have seen that we have created the rows inside a table, and lots of rows. So the next thing I want to show you is that, let's say we have a new table called, let's say test. It's a test table, and test table has ID, test table has user underscore ID, and test table has a name also. So ID is good, name will be varchar of let's say 191, and now save it. So we have created a table, and you can also create this table by going to the migration system, but I prefer this system, so that's not the that's not the point of debate. So let's go, and I want to create many of the rows inside this table, inside this test table. So go here, and what I want to do, I want to create here, obviously I want to say test, and I want to comment this out. So let's see how we will do that. Obviously we want to run the command, but it is giving an error. So why this error? Because when we have used factory, it is giving me no error, but we have getting the error. So we will resolve this error in the next video. So if you have any doubt in this episode, please feel free to comment me. If you have any doubt in other videos or in anywhere of your project, please feel free to comment me. I will always respond and ready to help you. You can follow me on Facebook, Twitter and Instagram. You can message me on Facebook, where I am very active. Please like Bitfumes on Facebook so that you will get the latest update about what is coming and what's going on in the Bitfumes channel. So we will meet in the next episode, and till then, be happy, goodbye, and share this video with your developer friends.